Welcome to the Big Band and Swing Podcast, brought to you by SwingCityRadio.com.
Got the jitters. Like the pounding of a hammer is a clatter and a clamor of Manhattan's panorama. Got the jitters. Going places. Sick and tired of those artificial faces. Or the chatter of the man that doesn't matter has me madder than a hatter. Got the jitters. Got a penthouse with a view. Never get a chance to see the view. Bought a shiny Cadillac. Always do the taxi there and back. Got the jitters. From the moment that I get up on the go without let up. Wait up, bring another set up. Got the jitters. Like a million other critters who are not exactly quitters. I'm a much bereaved man that's got the jitters.
I just love that song. That was Got the Jitters by Ben Pollock and his orchestra from 1934. Now, if you're not familiar with Ben Pollock, he was known as the father of swing. Not because he was a great drummer. I mean, he was average. And not because he was a great vocalist. The songs I've heard him sing, his voice was okay. The reason he was known as the father of swing was because he had a gift in surrounding himself with incredible musicians with top-shelf talent. His bands were the training grounds for some of the biggest names of the big band era. Ben Pollock was a one-man bandleader factory. In this episode, we're going to hear from just some of those alumni who went on to become bandleaders, and I'm quite sure you're going to recognize most of their names. Hello there, welcome back to the Big Band and Swing Podcast. I'm your host, Ronaldo. I've got an exciting show lined up for you today. As I said in the intro, we're going to be hearing from some alumni of those great Ben Pollock orchestras of the 1920s and 30s. All of these former band members went on to lead their own bands, so that means we'll be listening to tracks by Benny Goodman, Glenn Miller, Jack Teagarden, and many more. Before we get into things, I just want to quickly remind you about Swing City Radio. If you like the music you hear on this podcast, then you will just love Swing City Radio. Download the app on your smartphones, and then you'll always have great big band music right at your fingertips. Also, please consider supporting this podcast by joining my Patreon page. You can learn more at supportswing.com. That's supportswing.com. Oh, and I also got an email from a listener in Santa Monica, California, asking me, how long does it normally take to record an episode of this podcast? Well, I'll give you the short answer and maybe expand on this in a later episode. It could take anywhere between 3 to 6 hours per episode. The recording and the mixing down of the podcast is usually the easiest part, and once I have the songs chosen, the writing goes pretty quickly too. What can take time, though, is the cleaning up of all the music I play here. Sometimes the audio I get my hands on might be filled with static, pops, background noises, and so on. I know that many of you listen to this podcast through headphones, so I do my best to make the sound quality as enjoyable as possible. There's times I can tweak and tinker and get something to sound pretty good, and other times the raw audio is just so roached I just can't even include it. So please forgive me if a song sounds a little subpar quality-wise, I really do my best. Also, another time-consuming thing is the research and the hunt for these songs. But I said I was going to give you a quick answer, and that would be 3 to 6 hours. And I will add one last thing. I love this music and the history behind it, so to me, it's always time well spent, and I hope you feel the same way too. Thank you so much for the email, and if you'd like to email me your questions or comments, you can reach me at swingcityradio@gmail.com. So the first Ben Pollock alumni that I'm going to play for you is this guy, Benny Goodman. I kid, of course. This is Benny Goodman with Love Me or Leave Me. This is from a 1937 radio remote. You're listening to the Big Band and Swing Podcast. Thank you.
Father's Day is on its way, and here's a quick quiz for the ladies. What type of man is the head of your house? Is he rugged in the great outdoors? Does he help with household chores? Whichever type he is, he's bound to be the Old Spice type. So you and the kids treat him to Old Spice by Schulten. Finest grooming aids a man can use. Give Old Spice aftershave lotion, brisk and bracing, happiest ending a shave ever had, $1. Or something new in sets, aftershave lotion, men's cologne, and stick deodorant, handy for travel in a bright red box, $2. Or splurge with the captain's box, 5 great grooming aids in one handsome box, $5. There's a wide selection of Old Spice gifts, priced from $1 to $7. Finest grooming aids a man can use.
Old Spice means quality,
said the captain to the bosun, and all the pirates with the ship that sailed the ocean.
Thank you.
That was Bud Freeman and the Boys with Coquette. That was from a V-disc issued in May of 1947. We also heard Jack Teagarden with Wolverine. That was from a V-disc as well. That one was issued in January of 1947. And we started that set off with Benny Goodman. I also snuck in a vintage Old Spice commercial. Their marketing is quite different now, huh? So Benny Goodman, Jack Teagarden, and Bud Freeman. Those are some pretty big names to all come from one band, huh? Well, let's keep those names rolling. This is Glenn Miller with American Patrol from a radio remote recorded in December of 1943. You're listening to the Big Band and Swing Podcast.
Thank you. Thank you.
That was Yank Lawson with his version of Sugar and Muggsy Spanier with That's a Plenty. Both can be found on V-discs issued back in 1945. We also heard some Glenn Miller back there, too. Now, I know that Yank and Muggsy might not have been among the biggest names of the big band era, but they were very good bandleaders with large followings. And up next, I have a song by yet another Ben Pollock alumni, Joe Marsala with How High the Moon from January of 1948. Listen for the harp playing of Adele Gerard on this one. And we're going to end this episode with a great Harry James song, Sharp as a Tack. Yep, you heard right. I said end this episode. This one went very, very quick. I really enjoy playing all of these great bandleaders that just happened to be Ben Pollock alumni. I mean, what did I tell you? Ben Pollock was a one-man bandleader factory. Well, goodbye until next time. Enjoy these last two songs, and I'll be seeing you soon. Don't forget to support me and the podcast at supportswing.com. Thanks for listening. Thank you so much for listening to the Big Band and Swing Podcast. And hey, don't forget to subscribe and leave us a 5-star review. Also, if you want access to all types of bonus content and podcast extras, then consider supporting the podcast and becoming a Hepcat. Just visit patreon.com/swingcityradio or swingcityradio.com to learn more. If you'd like to email me your comments, questions, or would just like to say hello, you can email me at swingcityradio@gmail.com. The recordings played on this podcast, to the best of my knowledge, are considered public domain. The recordings have been cleaned up, edited, and touched up only to increase the enjoyment for the listener, and I do my best to credit the performers during the podcast. Please email me with any copyright concerns. I take great care to only use recordings, song versions, and other audio materials that are considered public domain, but I am only human, so let me know of any issues. The Big Band and Swing Podcast is brought to you by SwingCityRadio.com. Thanks for listening, everyone.